Welcome, Honky Tonkers. Our show today is volume one of a musical series that explores some of our most respected and beloved honky tonk heroes. These are not just the honky tonk classics, and they're certainly not the top 40 country hits. No, these are the honky tonk heroes chosen by some of our favorite musicians, artists who wrote songs that stand the test of time. The swinging two-steppers, the waltzes, and the country rockers that still make you want to get out on that honky-tonk hardwood floor. Ernest Tubbs' I'm Walking the Floor Over You is known as the first honky-tonk song, jump-starting the genre in 1941. But it wasn't until the 1950s that honky-tonk achieved mainstream popularity. Now, over the past 50 years, I am proud to say I've danced at honky-tonks in over 25 states, from New York City to the Midwest, and all over the South and the West Coast. I can tell you something about honky-tonking around. Honky-tonk attitude means you are there for the music, the dancing, and the drinking, maybe not in that order. That may be why I have worn holes in the soles of my cowboy boots. Most of these have been resoled at least once. Whether you're there for a tear in your beer, a whiskey river, or the honky-tonk blues, these juke joints are your home away from home. Some are tiny, like LA's Cinema Bar. Some are large, like Hernando's Hideaway in Memphis. And some are huge, like Billy Bob's Texas in Fort Worth. But they all share the same thing: a stage, a dance floor, and a bar, and the diverse musicians who make it all happen. Today, our video host, music historian Big Sandy, and special musical guests like Dave Alvin, Jesse Dayton, and Deke Dickerson are going to share their honky-tonk heroes with you. We are going to kick it off with a serious honky-tonker who has made music with Waylon, Willie, Chris, and Johnny in his honky-tonk career. Who can doubt his country credentials after he wrote the song, "I'm at home getting hammered while she's out getting nailed"? He won Honky Tonk Artist of the Year at the Ameripolitan Awards and is the host of his own Gimme Country radio station. Welcome from Austin, the outlaw Jesse Dayton.
Hey, hey, thanks, Chris. Got my old Martin here. How y'all doing? If you don't know who I am, my name's Jesse Dayton. I'm from an old Texas family, and I was raised on honky-tonk music and rockabilly music, and my family's an old Beaumont, Texas family, which is right on the Louisiana-Texas border, so I grew up listening to a lot of Zydeco and Cajun music and rhythm and blues, and quite a colorful place to grow up. We had, I mean, up until like the late 80s, we had 24-hour Cajun DJ stations where they spoke nothing but French. It'd be, ah, comment ça va, cher baby, and a lot of honky-tonk. A lot of country music came out of Beaumont, Starday Records, and so much stuff. I mean, a lot of the classic guys that I got to play with later told me great stories. Johnny Bush told me great stories about him and Lefty Frizzell recording in Beaumont. And anyway, like most musicians, guitar slingers, I made it out and went to Austin. That's where, you know, we all wanted to be if you were a Texan. And so I ended up in Austin, and I remember Clifford Antone, who Antone's Blues Club, who was from Port Arthur, and his family knew my family in Beaumont. He's like, "Oh, kid, just learn these Buddy Guy records and come to the club, and I'll get you up on stage." So I did, and I was really young, and I got up and I sang. And he goes, "You know, your voice is pretty country." And Clifford put me in his Continental car and took me over to the Broken Spoke and introduced me to James White. And I got up on stage. James got me up on stage. This is the first night ever to play in Austin. And I just played Antone's earlier with a house band, did a couple of songs, sang one song. And then I went up and sang a Johnny Bush song. And I was like, okay, yeah, this is where I'm supposed to be. Because Austin had this amazing classic country scene. We had a big rockabilly scene. It's like every Monday and Tuesday, like the two worst nights of the week, you could go to the Continental Club, the Black Cat Lounge, the Hole in the Wall, Antone's, the Broken Spoke. They'd all be packed and people would be dressed to the nines. So eventually, you know, I got a record deal and I was in Nashville and I was promoting this record I had out on this television show called Crook and Chase, which was a square kind of, it seemed like one of those Christian broadcasting networks where everybody's just super uptight. And I'm in there with my, you know, pompadour and sideburns and tattoos, and I do not fit in. And that night I met Christofferson on the show. Because this publicist had seen me at the Continental Club and said, hey, I'm going to get you on this show. You're never going to get on the radio, but I'll get you on this show. So I met Chris, and it was a great night. And me and Christofferson ended up hanging out the whole night together. We went outside and we, you know, smoked a little bit of Willie's jazz tea. And then we went to the Gibson Guitar Factory, which they opened at like 9 o'clock at night for Chris. And then we just sat around and talked about books and talked about Bukowski and songwriters and Hank Williams. And it was great. And I was like, okay, that's great. It's all over. That next morning, I was staying out in this dump because I couldn't even afford to stay next to Music Row, like this Motel 6, and my phone rings, and it's Waylon Jennings. And Waylon goes, hey, I saw you on TV last night, Hoss. Why don't you come down and pick some guitar for me? And it was a deal changer. So I ended up playing on all the guitar on the next Waylon Jennings record, and that opened up a lot of doors for me. And I ended up playing on a whole Ray Price record, and I recorded with Johnny Cash and recorded with Willie Nelson and Johnny Bush, and it just kept going on and on for a while. And I got to meet Billy Joe Shaver because we ended up on the same record label, and I also met him through Waylon. And those two were, they were such a hoot. They were so cool to hang out with. And Billy Joe, you know, just passed away not long ago. And I built a big old fire pit in my backyard and call it the Billy Joe Shaver Fire Pit. But anyway, there's a lot of stories. And I'm actually writing a book for this publishing company called DiCapo Book Publishing, which is going to have all these stories and in it. But anyway, there you have it. Thanks for listening to me ramble, and here's some way more Jennings.
Low down, leaving son. Done did everything it was done. Woe is me, why can't I see? I best believe in well enough alone. Where does it go? The good Lord only knows. Seemed like it was just the other day. I was down in Green Gables, hogging them tables, and generally blowing all my hard-earned pay by any road blues. Machine. There weren't another way to be. For them lovable losers, no account losers, and honky tonk heroes like me. I was down in Green Gables,
Hey y'all, this next video is one of my favorites. Filmed right here in Austin at the legendary Continental Club. I was supposed to be in this video. So many of my friends are, but I was actually on tour. I think I was up in Canada or Seattle at the time. But yeah, it's got Billy Joe Shaver's son just melting faces on his guitar, Eddie Shaver, great guitar player. And to me, it's just one of the greatest all-time hillbilly rock and roll songs ever. Anyway, this is Billy Joe Shaver doing the hottest thing in town.
She's the queen of the red hot mama, hottest thing around. When she shows up at a honky tonk, 'cause she can righteously get down, you know she get on down. From down to the ground, she's a cat's meow and a dog's bow wow, the hottest thing in town. A friend of a friend of a friend of mine said he knew her well. Said she hung around heaven till she learned too much, then she headed straight for hell. She went straight to hell. Everything for sale. She walks the walk and talks the talk, the hottest thing in town. She's the hottest thing in town by country mile.
Just want to say thanks so much for letting me be a part of this. Thank you, Christopher. Also, I'd be remiss if I didn't bring up my dear friend, Big Sandy, who's just a legend. And I've known him for so long. Like, I don't know when it was. It was the early 90s, maybe, when my little band first opened up for the original Big Sandy outfit with TK, and High Noon was on that gig. You guys might remember that band, High Noon. We were playing a rockabilly festival at the Hole in the Wall in Austin. Yeah, I love Robert. I love everything you do, man. You're not just a rockabilly singer. You know, hillbilly boogie and western swing and honky tonk and doo-wop and just so much there. So anyway, thanks for letting me be a part of this. God bless you guys. And hopefully we'll see you back on tour in the near future. Take care.
Thank you, Jesse. And welcome, music lovers. Big Sandy here, very happy to be part of today's presentation, Honky Tonk Heroes, Volume 1. And my favorite part about that equation is that it's Volume 1, meaning more episodes to come. Today, I'll be sharing but a few of my many Honky Tonk Heroes. All right, let's get started. Warren Smith, first recorded for Sam Phillips at Sun Records in Memphis, and he laid down some of the finest examples of rockabilly ever committed to wax with songs like Got Love If You Want It, Rock and Roll Ruby, and Miss Froggy. But mixed in with all of that beautiful rock and roll madness at Sun, Warren Smith also recorded some sides that showed a real feel for true authentic country music. After he left Sun Records, Warren was signed to the Liberty record label, where he went on to release some of my all-time favorite honky tonk records and what I think is one of the greatest country music albums of all time. Here he is, live on the Gene Williams Country Junction, the great Warren Smith.
I guess you never met her, boy, but she was a dream. She was a queen, my everything. One night we had a quarrel and I don't know what for. She walked through the door with all my dreams. That's why I sing in a honky tonk where lights are low. Broken heart them come and go. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk sad melody, so this broken heart of mine will have some company. This is where she left me, boy, and here's where I'll stay. Here I will play my life away, hoping for the day to come when she will return. Her kisses will burn my hurt away. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk where lights are low. Broken hearts by hundreds, I see them come and go. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk sad melody, so this broken heart of mine will have some company.
Thank you very much.
Was I farther from your conscience standing face to the war? I suspected there was something that you weren't telling me. And last night I learned the reason for it all. I was looking through your window, saw you kissing someone else. You reached up and turned my picture slowly face to the wall, face to the wall, so you wouldn't have to see anything at all to make you think of me. Did the cheapness of the moment make you feel ashamed and small? Was I farther from your conscience standing face to the wall? Alone out in the darkness were the eyes that worship you. As you cheated me, I watched my idol fall. Your arms around did nothing, his lips where mine should be. Then I saw you turn my picture slowly face to the wall, face to the wall, so you wouldn't have to see anything at all to make you think of me. In the cheapness of the moment make you feel ashamed and small? Was I farther from your conscience standing face to the wall?
Oh my goodness, what can I say? Pure perfection right there, from one of the great voices of all time in country music, Farron Young. Along with another one of the great voices of all time in country music, Johnny Paycheck. Then known as, you know it, Donnie Young. Now the trouble that those two got up to, my goodness. Along with some of their other musical cohorts, they kind of laid the groundwork for troublemaking and honky-tonkers and country outlaws for years to come. We'll have more of Johnny Paycheck as the show unfolds. But for now, just because he's one of my biggest honky-tonk heroes, Farron Young.
Well, this old picture is so faded you can hardly see. And that smiling face there in the middle, well, you can see it's me. And that pretty girl there on my left was mine to hold the fire, but I lost her to my friends.
there on the right. And that big house you see there in the background, that big shiny car I bought to drive her around. And just to keep her happy, I work hard both day and night. Now it all belongs to my friend there on the right. The picture told the truth, but I was oh, oh so blind. I was the guy in the middle of the fight. I built my hopes up till they were out of sight, and watched her walk away with my friend there on the right. Showed the truth, but I was oh, oh so blind. I was the guy in the middle of all the time. I built my hopes up till they were out of sight, and watched her walk away with my friend there on the right. I watched her walk away with my friend there on the floor.
And Woody had a crew haircut. He was the all-American boy. And I remember he came in, he was singing songs to people, and he sang me a particular song. He said, "I've sang this for everybody. There's no use in singing it for you." I said, "Well, sing it to me. I'd like to hear."
Hello, Wendy. Well, I see.
He sang me two songs. I said, "I'll take them both. I'm going to record them."
Since our darling disappeared.
A few of you guys were sitting around and I sang it, and everybody laughed. They was going around and said, "Hello, commode. Hello, bathtub. Hello, sink. Where did you get that terrible piece of material?" And I sang it to Sue. She said, "That's a hit, honey. You cut that thing." And me and you laughed all the way at the bank, didn't we? Yeah.
I tried to sell it to you one time. Remember that?
He did. He tried to sell me Hello Walls for $500. Because I told him how many it sold. He thought I was hyping it, you know. I said, "No, don't you sell this song. I'm going to loan you some money." And I loaned him the money. And about 6 weeks later, he got another check for like $20,000. I was sitting in Tooses, and this arm came around my neck, squeezed my mouth open, and he French kissed me. And it was the best kiss I ever had. And we've been close ever since.
I've always loved that Willie and Farron Hello Walls story. Probably heard it 100 times, and maybe you have too, but it's kind of fun to hear it together, isn't it? I think so. Before that, of course, the beautiful voice of the great Farron Young. I'll be back in a flash with many more Honky Tonk Heroes.
Hey friends, next up we're going to hear Honky Tonk Man by the singing fisherman Johnny Horton. Song is recorded January 11th, 1956 at Bradley Studios in Nashville, Tennessee, and it features Grady Martin on electric guitar and Bill Black on a doghouse bass. You might have heard Dwight Yoakam's version. This is the original. Honky Tonk Man, Johnny Horton.
A jug of wine, that's what it takes to make a honky tonk mind. With the jukebox a-moaning, a honky tonk sound. That's when I wanna lay my money down, 'cause I'm a honky tonk man. I can't seem to stop. I love to give the girls a whirl to the music of an old jukebox. But when my money's all gone, I'm on the telephone hollering, "Hey, hey, mama, can your daddy come home?"
Well, 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 Mark Christian here, singer, songwriter, and guitarist with the band Merle Jagger. And I would just love for you to check out one of my favorite honky-tonk Ameripolitan artists, Johnny Falstaff from Houston, Texas. Now, Johnny moved to Germany, tours Europe and America too. Johnny released his first record in 2008, but has a new one out from 2020 called Lost in the City Lights. Let's hear a track from Johnny's new record right now called Stars.
Put on your traveling shoes, I'm taking you to the stars. Me and you are one, true love can be ours. We're flying far beyond the sun, a place in space to call our own. Oh, let it be known, let's be perfectly clear, I'm holding someone special and I'm holding you near. Traveling shoes, I'm taking you to the stars. Me and you are one, true love can be ours.
Hope you're enjoying our Honky Tonk Heroes show today. It may be time to slip a few quarters in the virtual jukebox to help support these artists, and you can do it at StellarJAX.com. Let's get back to the music with our video host, Big Sandy.
All right, I'm back. Big Sandy here again with a few more of my Honky Tonk Heroes. Now, for Wood County, Texas, Ray Price, a giant in the country music world for decades, and a name that some people most associate with the Nashville sound, that smooth Nashville sound. All right. But Ray Price and this song forever changed country music. That is a fact. This is my opinion. It may not have been the very first country 45 to use this rhythm, the rhythm that became known as country shuffle, but it is the earliest example of a big country hit to use it, and certainly the first to make it a thing. It became the Ray Price Shuffle, so there you go. But that country shuffle sound and feel kind of became a genre unto itself in the honky tonk music world. Let's take a look right now. Ray Price.
Storms brewing in this heart of mine. This ain't no crazy dream. I know that it's real. You're someone
I don't intend to spend too much time in here. But I heard you matching for the jukebox. And if you play A11, there'll be tears. I don't know you from Adam, but if you're gonna play the jukebox, please don't play A11.
You know, I'm awful glad that the Job Corps didn't get you, because we need you.
Me too.
Johnny Paycheck and a whole bunch of cowboys are brewing up country's best on K-Tell's Kickin' Country.
I teamed up with Willie Nelson, Jerry Reed, Roy Hazard, Ray Jeff Walker, and a whole bunch of cowboys.
Kickin' Country is just a bunch of good old boys.
You take it from me, the old outlaw, it is a standy.
All right, there he is again, and again, Mr. Johnny Paycheck. It's sometimes hard for me to think of those two guys as being the same person, just a decade apart. I think it might have been a little tougher for Johnny to come to terms with, too. But we'll be seeing even more of him a little bit later. For this debut episode of Honky Tonk Heroes, I'd like to introduce a new segment, where through the help of vintage video, I bring the spotlight in a little closer on an unsung honky tonk artist. Vernon Oxford was a hardcore honky tonk singer with unlucky timing, coming up in an era when traditional country simply wasn't hitting it on the charts. Born in Rogers, Arkansas in 1941, Oxford grew up sitting in his room, playing his guitar, and listening to Hank Williams records until the wee hours. His struggles in his music career led to a battle with the bottle in the 60s, but he got back on track in the 70s, being rediscovered in the UK, and found solace serving in his local church.
Well, roll, big wheel, roll, sang me a lonesome song. Roll, big wheels roll, the old boys are going home. From the Indian River to old Kentucky, it's a 17-hour drive. I'll into the terminal, turning the log, and bid this rig goodbye. Been a wheeling this big red diesel of all everything you can name. From the Lone Star State to the Motor City, from her Frisco to Caribou, Maine. Every time that I left home hurt me worse than the time before. When I reach the bill on a tether seal, I won't be leaving no more. Well, roll, big wheel, roll, sing me your lonesome song. Roll, big wheels roll, these old boys are going home. That sign of red said straight ahead to Louisville, KY. I'll into the terminal, turn in the log, and bid this rig goodbye.
The neon lights of Nashville attract many mountain folk who aim to make it big in the country music business. Vernon Oxford left his home in the country while still a child. He came to Nashville dreaming of stardom on the country music scene. but only after hitting rock bottom in the bars and dives of Nashville.
I know the bar on the corner makes it need you. The crowd believes your dancing makes them gay. But our family pride can't take this any longer.
Started drinking, I must have been 14 or so, and I, you know, drank beer and played my guitar. Didn't run around, I stayed home, you know, and just play and sing. I sang the old Hank Williams stuff and cry. So I think this song right here kind of explains a lot of it.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
A Man Born Out of Time, a throwback really. Vernon Oxford, today's unsung Honky Tonk hero. And now, a hero of many, certainly of mine, a champion of American music. I'd like to throw it to Dave Alvin.
Hey Robert, it's your old pal Dave Alvin, and I'd like to play a song by my favorite honky tonk singer, Wynn Stewart. Now for those of you who've never heard of Wynn Stewart, Wynn was one of the architects of the West Coast country sound back in the 1950s. He had a band that included the great Ralph Mooney on pedal steel, the astounding Roy Nichols on electric lead guitar, and he occasionally had a bass player named Merle Haggard. So if you don't believe me, just go ask Merle. All right, now I'd like to play this video of Wynn Stewart being backed up by Buck Owens' Buckaroos doing his beautiful song, Wishful Thinking. And if we were in a honky-tonk right now, I'd be playing this on the jukebox.
My heart echoes the love words you've spoken. How I wish I could hear them from you. Won't you answer this heart that's broken? and make my wishful thinking come true.
Billy Joe Shaver is the inspiration for this eclectic American roots series that we call Honky Tonk Heroes, because that is exactly who Billy Joe was. Since the age of 12, he spent most of his life in honky tonks and made a name for himself through his songwriting and his irrepressible personality. Billy Joe Shaver was a bona fide, certified Lone Star original, a throwback to a far different time. It was echoed in the music he wrote and performed over a very adventurous life. He died in 2020 at age 81, but left a body of work that will inspire songwriters for ages to come. Willie Nelson called Shaver the greatest living songwriter, and Johnny Cash called him my favorite songwriter. His songs were recorded by Elvis Presley, Willie Nelson, David Allan Coe, Johnny Cash, and Waylon Jennings, among many others. Shaver's own debut album, Old Five and Dimers, was produced by Christofferson in 1973. Shaver's career is the stuff of legends. As a young man, he had been thumbing west to California, but couldn't get a ride, so he simply crossed the road and headed east, ending up in Nashville instead. He got a job writing songs for $50 a week, but it wasn't until Waylon Jennings heard one at a Willie Nelson picnic that his work really caught fire. Jennings recorded the first Outlaw album in 1973, and he titled it Honky Tonk Heroes, using nearly all Shaver's songs on that album. I'm proud to say that we had Billy Joe and his band perform at the legendary Don the Beachcomber. Arriving late with his band all ready to go, Shaver clambered up onto the tiki stage and observed, "It's like a jungle in here." A few years later, Shaver headlined the Long Beach Folk Festival. As the MC, I was getting ready to introduce his appearance when word came he was in the emergency room, having fallen flat on his face after the sound check. We altered the lineup so he could perform last, and just before his show, he came limping up to me, his face all skinned up and still dripping blood. I asked if he could still perform, and he gave me that big old Texas smile and said, "Why not?" He took the stage that night, still dripping blood off his face, onto the mic, and all over his denim shirt. His performance was typical Shaver. He never missed a beat and played the entire set without stopping.
And I just thought I'd mention, my grandma's old age pension is the reason why I'm standing here today. I got all my country learning, milking and a churning, digging cotton, raising, hailing, baling hay. I've been to Georgia on a fast train, honey. I wasn't born no yesterday. Got a good Christian raising and a great education. Ain't no needin' y'all are treating me this way. Guess I'll ever find another woman put together like you are. Oh, you're wiggling, you're walking, and you're big city talking. Your brand new shiny Plymouth ragtop car. Hey, let's hurry up and wait in this world of give and take. Seem like haste and makes for waste every time. I declare to my soul, when you hear those ages roll, you better know I'm gonna get my share of mine.
He released over a dozen albums with varying success over the years. In 1996, he took a part in the film The Apostle, playing opposite Robert Duvall. He had additional acting roles in other movies. In 2007, Billy Joe Shaver was charged with shooting a man who was rude to his ex-wife outside a bar near his home in Waco. Witnesses testified Shaver asked the victim, "Where do you want it?" and then pointed a .22 pistol at his cheek and pulled the trigger. The trial drew friends, including Willie Nelson and actor Robert Duvall, in support of Shaver. He claimed self-defense, and he was acquitted. He went on to turn the ordeal into a song, Wacko from Waco. His pal, Dale Watson, also wrote a song about the event. Where do you want it?
South of Waco! Yeah. Please come, Papa Jules, I heard him say so. That man named Billy Jules. God in his angle. From a border knife, Billy Ford is good. But a cat I know he is. Billy has been son. Where do you want it? Born to where you want to build the thing, cause I'm gonna give it my best name. Oh, I want it. Leave me alone. Where do you want it?
Shaver could never catch a break as a mainstream artist on his own. After his debut album, Old Five and Dimers, was released in 1973, the label went out of business.
I've spent a lifetime making up my mind to be more than the measure of what I thought others could see. Well, good luck and fast bucks are too few and too far between. There's Cadillac buyers and old five and dimers like me. Well, she stood beside me, a letting him know she would be something to lean on if everything ran out on me. Well, fence yards ain't whole cards, and like as not, never will be. Reasons for rhymers and old five and dimers like me. Taken me so long, and now that I know I believe, all that I do or say is all I ever will be. Well, too much ain't enough for old five and dimers like me. Too far, too high, and too deep ain't too much to see. An old five and dimer is all I intended to be. Thank you very much. God bless all of you.
Shaver always said he was welcome anywhere he went because he wrote good music. He didn't have the management and stuff like that. They said he was unmanageable. Shaver said, I'm a songwriter first and whatever else I do second. He enjoyed the heck out of entertaining, and the songs were like the cheapest psychiatrist there is. Of course, then Shaver added, he pretty much needs one all the time.
Remember, someone really loves you. We'll live forever, you and I. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow night. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow night. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow night.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hello, my name is Petunia. I'm coming at you from Vancouver, BC, on the unceded territory of the Squamish, Musqueam, and Tsleil-Waututh Nations. Lefty Frizzell is one of my honky-tonk heroes. I try and emulate him, or I was, every Monday night we had a honky-tonk happening here in Vancouver. He's influenced just about everyone that came after him. I mean, George Jones, if I think of George Jones, he seems to be, I mean, I guess the biggest star after, country star after Lefty. And he probably, I think of George Jones as an emulation of Lefty Frizzell, Hank Williams, and George himself. And then you can just go on from there and trace who's come and imitated George and so forth. So up to the modern country singer, they all have that dipsy doodly kind of way of singing that Lefty made really famous. And I suppose he would have been more famous in his time, except that he toured with Hank Williams. So Hank was of course the main headline fame guy. And Lefty traces his roots to Jimmy Rogers. So it's not as obvious if you look at Jimmy and you think, wow, the dipsy doodle is not as obvious. You know, when I say dipsy doodle, like, I love you, I'll prove it in days to come. Like, it's all sorts of, you could just say, I love you, I'll prove it in days to come. But instead, he adds all these other things that became more and more pronounced as country music evolved. And I guess I just love his songs. I love his style. I love his panache. I heard he had his own language that he used on stage. I would love to see some of that. So Lefty Frizzell is one of my honky tonk heroes. We're gonna hear "I Love You a Thousand Ways," which I've just given you a little bit of a segment of.
I'll be nice and sweet to you, and no more will you be blue. I'll prove I love you every day, all kinds of ways. So darling, please wait until I'm free. There'll be a change, a great change made in me. I'll be true, there'll never be a blue day. I love you, I'll prove it a thousand ways.
Hey everyone, hope you're all enjoying the show. I'm Sue of Little Sue and the Cowtrippers, a honky tonk band based right here in Duarte, California. And I'm very honored to get to introduce my honky tonk hero, Miss Loretta Lynn. Miss Loretta Lynn wrote this song while living in Washington very early in her career. She had been singing in a local country band and was inspired when she met a woman at a bar right after a show. And while the woman, a little tipsy, sat down and told her over some drinks her tale of heartbreak. Sound familiar? So this is what inspires me about her. Her songs are always about loving and losing, but also coming back strong and not taking anything from anybody. Like songs like "This City" or "Don't Come Home a Drinking." So without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and let you hear what we're gonna play for you. One of my favorite songs and one of the first recorded songs that she ever did. Miss Loretta Lynn singing, "I'm a Honky Tonk Girl." Enjoy.
Many nights I laid awake and cried.
not hard to see just what I am. I'm ashamed and I'm sorry for everything you see, but losing him has made a fool of me. So turn
Sandy back again, and I can see there that some of you have some drinks going. Well, just be careful with that. It's time for George Jones, one of the great voices in American music, period, any genre. Also a man who had a lifelong battle with the bottle and other substances. He truly lived out the template for Honky Tonk Livin' 101 is laid down by his hero as a teenager, Hank Williams.
Let him take me to jail.
But you're not going to do that.
Wait a minute,
what have I done?
You are drunk. I want to
talk. I am not.
Yes, you are.
No, sir.
George, hey, come on then, George.
You make a real ass out
of yourself, George. Wait a minute, Dave. All right, kid, I don't know.
I just don't give a damn.
But let's remember him this way, as one of the greatest singers of all time, and one of today's Honky Tonk Heroes.
Oh, the faucet started dripping in the kitchen.
That's George Jones.
And last night your picture fell down from the wall. Today the boss said sorry, I can't use you anymore. And tonight the light bulb went out in the hall. Things have gone to pieces since you left me. Nothing turned out half right, now it seems. There ain't nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. But I'm holding to the pieces of my dream. Somebody threw a baseball through my window, and the arm fell off my favorite chair again. The man, he came today and said he'd haul my things away if I didn't get my payments made by 10. Things have gone to pieces since you left me. Nothing turns out half right, now it seems. Nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. But I'm holding to the pieces of my dream.
Tremendous, George.
Here comes right at the back stretch. Our eggs are going to the inside. My dear, the hole in there, they're trying to gone and it looks like heartache, and the winter loses his all. One day I ventured in love, never once suspecting what the final result would be. I'll live in fear of waking up each morning and finding that you're gone from me. Waking in pain in my heart for the day, the one that I hated to face. Somebody new came up to win her, and I came out in second place.
Well, the race is
on and new on pride at the back street. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back, they're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running, who loves that for another's sake? The race is on and it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all.
Man, a delightful double helping of the great George Jones. Also, there's old Johnny Paycheck again. And I don't mind that at all. I hope you don't either. A lot of the clips that I use on this program are culled from live country music TV shows from the 50s and 60s, and those are treasures. But I also like when we get to take a little closer look behind the curtain and beyond the rhinestones when the bright lights grow dim. James O'Gwynn grew up like a lot of young honky-tonk hopefuls under the spell of Jimmy Rogers and then later Hank Williams. He charted with songs on the D Label, Mercury Records, and United Artists. But here he is at home alone with his guitar after the hits stopped coming. Another honky-tonk hero, James O'Gwynn.
I won't love you any more than you love me. Think I'll keep on waiting for your love while you keep dating other fellows in this town who thinks you're free. I can't give something dear for nothing. Surely this time I'm not bluffing. I won't love you any more than you love me. You like worldly ways and riches, pretty clothes with fancy stitches, and you think you're living best with all of these. Not right to love you more than you love me. I can't run around with everyone the way you do. So why must I be the one who sits and cries the blues? This love affair is far from even, and I believe in Stephen, Stephen. I won't love you any more than you love me.
At home with James O'Gwynn. I do love that. I'll be back in a little bit with some Honky Tonk Heroes of a more recent vintage. But first, a visit from Doug and Freddie.
Ay, ay, ay.
infatuated to the point, a lot of people look alike, they sound alike, the same musicians on every record, the same tones, the same amps, that all of a sudden you can't tell who's what anymore. And when we were growing up, when you heard Webb go, wandering, wandering, and you heard Lefty go, I love you, I'm proving it, everybody was distinctive.
You wouldn't read my letter if I wrote you. And you asked me not to call you on the phone. But there's something I've been wanting to tell you.
If he brings you happiness, then I wish you all the best. It's your happiness that matters most of all. Wasted days and wasted nights that I have left for you behind. I can't remember when I didn't love you. There was a time I thought you felt the same. Holy one, you'll never know how much I love you so. And I'll be there before the next teardrop falls.
Hi, I'm Bill Kirchin, and here's one of my all-time favorite top honky-tonk heroes, Mr. Red Simpson. And Red was right there in the middle of the heyday of the Bakersfield country music scene. He was a great writer. He wrote Close Up the Honky-Tonks. He wrote a number one hit for Buck Owens, Sam's Place. And he also wrote a song that Merle Haggard must have liked because he cut it three times, which was, If You're Trying to Break My Heart, You Don't Have Very Far to Go. So Red made great records of his own. His very first capital LP was called Roll Truck Roll originally. Later was released as Hello, I'm a Truck when he had hit of that in the 70s. But it came out in about 67, I think, produced by Ken Nelson. I got it in 67. And it flipped me out. And it was one of the greatest, if not the greatest, truck driving albums of all time, I do believe. And this, of course, was back when truck driving music was a major important genre. Of course, I still think it is. That's me. Anyway, here he is, the mighty Red Simpson.
Well, that old trailer leaned each time that I took another curve. My hands started sweating and I knew I was losing my nerve. And I was cussing each rock and every inch of the devil's crest. While fighting with the wheel of a rig called the Nitro Express. I sideswiped the mountain so I'd slow her down by rubbing her side. And when the sparks started flying, man, it looked like the 4th of July. I finally got her stopped, but mister, I'm gonna confess. Well, that's the last run I'm making in a rig called the Nitro Express. There was 36 ton of a detonated steel over 18 tires that smoked and squealed. I had to ride her down, I couldn't jump free or there'd be a big hole where that little town used to be. There was 36 ton of a detonated steel over 18 tires that smoked and squealed. I had to ride her down, I couldn't jump free or there'd be a big hole where that little town used to be.
All right, let's talk for a second about Webb Pierce. You know, if we're talking about Honky Tonk Heroes, you know, obviously when you get down to the nuts and bolts of country western music and all of its little different tree limbs that are going off of the big tree, you know, Honky Tonk, it's about drinking beer, it's about cheating songs, and there was really nobody that ushered that in more than a guy named Webb Pierce back in the early 1950s. And Webb Pierce had one of those classic super nasal voices. Some people like it, some people don't. But one thing that happened back then was a guy like Webb Pierce with a real nasally voice like that, when you played him on a jukebox, his voice would just cut through the mix. You know, you could instantly tell that it was Webb Pierce. And I love Webb Pierce. He's got so many good songs. The song that we actually do a few Webb Pierce songs with the Whippersnappers. But little thing called Walking the Dog, which is really kind of a cheating song. And he had so many good ones. There Stands the Glass. We do that one too every now and then. It's a classic beer drinking song. And then, of course, there's a great YouTube clip from a 1965 movie where Webb does this song called I Ain't Never. And I Ain't Never, back in when he released it, was not a huge hit for him. But it's one of those songs that, like, every honky-tonk band covers now. So hats off to Webb Pierce, the great honky-tonk hero.
Nobody but you. You call me up.
Friends, Big Sandy back, and I hope you're having a good time here this afternoon. I'm digging it thoroughly. Honky Tonk Heroes. Now, for this round of clips, I'm going to take a look at some artists from more recent decades. As the honky tonk tradition continues through the years, a new generation always comes along to inspire the next. Case in point, I can think of many dozens of young artists who have been inspired by the music of Wayne Hancock. And I think that this song of his can stand up right next to any one of the classics of the genre. Here's Wayne as a younger man, channeling perhaps some of the ghosts of his childhood honky tonk heroes. It's a thing of beauty. Watch, Wayne Hancock.
There's some big black clouds from the west. I've been driving all day, Lord, I sure could use some rest. There's a motel up ahead where I can unwind, 'cause it sure love thunderstorms and neon signs. I grew up on the road from town to town. My daddy's line of work kept us moving around. I got fond memories of the way things were back then. The warmth of the neon when a bad storm was moving in. Well, listen to the Opry and Small Cafe when we stopped to get a bite along the way. Whenever I hear the wheels begin to wind, it takes me back to another time. I got a real
hotel, motel 11 is the only life for me. And it looks like it'll be raining for quite some time. Mixed with the lightning is the glow from a neon sign. Stop to get a bite along the way. Whenever I hear the wheels begin to wind, it takes me back to another time. There's some big black cloud floating from the west. I've been driving all day, Lord, I sure could use some rest. There's a motel up ahead where I can unwind. Cause it sure love thunderstorms and neon signs. Lord, I sure love thunderstorms and neon signs.
Friends and I get together every night at the tavern at Broadway First, where we sit way in the back, me, Jill, Rose and Jack, where we silently work on our Gypsy Road. They're always wherever I go. They're the only friends I've got, and I'm proud I've got to know Jill B, Jack Daniels, sweet Gypsy Road. They don't resist my shaky hand. They said listen, and I never must insist. The Gypsy Rose watches my eyes, and if she thinks I'm about to cry, she caresses my lips with her kiss. Jill B, Gypsy Road. They're always wherever I go. They're the only friends I've got, and I'm proud I've got to know Jill B, Jack Daniels, sweet Gypsy Road.
A Texas legend in his own right, Jake Hooker, doing a song by one of his Honky Tonk heroes, Johnny Bush. Now, we lost Johnny Bush last year, sadly, but as you can hear there, his music lives on. Jake Hooker. Honky Tonk music is a true American art form, but its influences have reached far beyond the confines of this nation. Take, for example, the countryside of Harmonica Sam, a group of fine young gentlemen from Sweden who are carrying on the honky tonk tradition in a wonderful way, influencing young people throughout the world. Here they are in their latest video release, The Countryside of Harmonica Sam.
I'm not myself this evening, please excuse me, my old friend. There's just so many memories in this world I am living in, and they're really getting to me. I don't know if I can stand another aching, breaking heartache for the first time again. It's the first time I felt this way since the last time I felt this way, and I don't want you to see me when those lonely teardrops start. So excuse me if I'm not the happy guy I'm supposed to be. It's my first broken heart since my last broken heart. And I don't want you to see me when those lonely teardrops start. So excuse me if I'm not the happy guy I'm supposed to be. It's my first broken heart since my last broken heart.
How about that? Let them know. Countryside of Harmonica Sam. I'm going to throw it over to Carolyn Sills in just a moment. But first, I want to remind you that this is Honky Tonk Heroes, Volume 1. Looking forward to Volume 2, Volume 3. More to come. We already have a long list raring to go for the next program, including a group of fine women honky tonkers. But please let us know who you'd like to hear in the future. Leave comments on any of the posts associated with this on Facebook or on YouTube. Honky Tonk Heroes. Hope you've enjoyed it. Ladies and gentlemen, here now is Carolyn Sills.
Hi, everybody. I'm Carolyn Sills.
And I'm Gerard.
And we're from the Carolyn Sills Combo.
And we're here today to talk about our friend, Mr. James Hand, or as he was better known by many of his friends and fans, simply Slim. We had a chance to play a handful of shows with Slim in Southern California a few years back, thanks to Mr. Chris Burkhardt at Stellar Shows. And, you know, it's one thing to listen to James Hand songs on the record, but when you see him live, when you talk to him in person, you look into those sweet, sad puppy dog eyes, you realize he is the real deal.
Certainly is. And there's a lot of great honky-tonk songwriters out there, but it's a rare breed that actually live the honky-tonk life. And I think James lived every last word, even down to penning what he hoped would be the epitaph on his tombstone. We miss him dearly, we wish he was still here, and we visit him all the time through his music. It's a real honor to present to you Mr. James Hand singing In the Corner at the Table by the Jukebox.
We love you, Slim.
In the corner at my table by the jukebox, my favorite mourners, and I talk about his old hard knock. Our life measured there by the bar clock, in the corner at my table by the jukebox.
So step inside where love has died, and you'll sure find me with sadness and a haunted face that's bound to be hidden behind the door that sorrow has locked. In the corner at my table by the jukebox, talk about these old roadblocks. For here is where the sorrow don't ever stop. In the corner at my table by the jukebox. So step inside where love has died, and you sure find me with sadness in a haunted face.
Thanks, Carolyn and Gerard. James Hand was one of the many honky-tonk talents the world lost in 2020, along with artists like Jerry Jeff Walker, Charlie Pride, John Prine, Johnny Bush, and Billy Joe Shaver. He was my hero and my friend, and there was nobody more reminiscent of the original Hank Williams than that old crooning cowboy. Although James only wanted to be known as the original James Hand. He was a mainstay in the Ameripolitan world, where they awarded him the honor of the Founder of the Sound Award in 2014, and he was the opener at every Ameripolitan Awards show since. James once said that his life wrote all of his songs, and he just tried to remember the words. Okay, Honky Tonk lovers, that's our show, Volume 1 of Honky Tonk Heroes. Be sure to leave a tip before you close up the Honky Tonks. We create this Eclectic American Roots series to explore all the nooks and crannies of roots music, and we invite you to visit YouTube to see all our episodes in one place. Just go to our StellarJAX channel. Hasta la vista! Till next time.